To check out all our products, go to musicnomadcare.com.
Hey, it's Rand from Music Nomad, here to talk about all the features and benefits of our high-quality precision setup gauges using the Keep It Simple setup method.
Hey, it's Jeff Luttrell, master guitar tech and owner of San Francisco Guitar Works and Sonoma County Guitar Works, and I'm here to show you how to use all the precision gauges used in the Keep It Simple setup method.
What if you can get accuracy, readability, quality, and functionality in one string action gauge? Winner. Being able to measure your string action is a critical step in the setup process. Music Nomad's precision string action gauge is packed with unmatched features and benefits. Starting with accurate measurements that are easy to read with the black finish contrasted with the deep etched white markings. The high quality stainless steel design combined with numbers and lines that don't rub off ensures years of use. Our smooth, polished edges won't scratch your frets and it's safe to use around your instrument. We include measurements in inches, metric, and 64ths to customize to your preference. Our convenient chart on proper height by instrument type takes out the guesswork. The pickup ruler helps you dial in your sound even more. And it even comes with a convenient hang hole.
So now I'm ready to measure my string action height. So that's the height of the string over the 12th fret. And to do that, I'm going to use my string action gauge. Now there are a lot of string action gauges out there, and we put a lot of time and a lot of thought into how to improve what is seemingly a very simple tool. You're going to use this tool all the time. I mean, this is one of the most important measuring tools that we use at the shop is a string action gauge. Use it for pickup height, use it for string height, use it for just general measuring. It's really, really handy, and you'll get a lot of mileage out of it. So a few things that I wanted on this gauge that I think make it the best one on the market. It's easy to see. So you've got a black background with white lines and white numbers, which is, it's just behind the string. There can be shadows, you can have, you know, different issues with lighting, and the white line really pops out of that black background, and it's much easier to see than the other gauges that I've used. We have the most commonly used action heights listed for acoustic, electric, and bass right on the gauge. So through my shop, I've done, I mean, thousands and thousands of setups. So knowing what works for the average player has really led to these specifications. I know that if most people use these specs, they're going to have a guitar that plays great for them because I hear that feedback from our customers all the time. So that's the real world knowledge that has gone into the specs on this and the design of this gauge. Also, what's really handy about this is you have 64ths, you have metric, and you have standard thousandths of an inch. So no matter how you like to measure your instrument's action, you have that readily available and easy to see. There's also metric and SAE rulers on the end, which is really handy if you just have something that you need to take a quick measurement of, that's right there. And then you have your pickup height scales, both metric and SAE. So this gauge has really been fantastic to use, and we use it constantly all day, and I think that you won't find a better one out there. So in order to measure my action height, I'm going to have my instrument in tune, and I'm going to put it in the playing position. Now, we're going to need to fret at the first fret, so you can either do that with your finger, or you can use the Music Nomad pick capo. I'm going to go ahead and just slide that in over the low E string. So I'll take my string action gauge and I'll put it behind the low E string at the 12th fret, and I'll find which line meets the bottom of the string at the 12th fret. So you'll use the chart to find the most common setting for your instrument. For electric standard setup, we would go with a low medium action at 60 thousandths on the bass side and 50 thousandths on the treble side. After you've gotten your action measurement on your low E string, you'll move to the high E string and do exactly the same thing. So fretting at the first fret on your high E string, you can either fret with your finger or you can use your pick capo. Depress the string at the first fret, take your string action gauge and place it behind the high E string at the 12th fret and see which line lines up with the string. Music Nomad screwdriver and wrench set is really easy to use, and it has all the commonly used bits that you'll need for taking off your truss rod cover, adjusting your saddles. It has a wrench that you can use for lifting tunamatic wheels, all kinds of stuff. So this kit is really great to have around. So after checking your action height, you've determined on your gauge that you've fallen outside the most common measurement. So you'll need to raise or lower your action to achieve that measurement. The Tunamatic Bridge, which is very common on a Gibson Les Paul, has a fixed radius and is supported on either end by a post. So you'll raise and lower that bridge by turning those posts up or down, raising or lowering the bridge. The way that it works is the posts have thumb wheels that you can grip, and you can turn clockwise to lower the bridge or counterclockwise to raise the bridge. Now, sometimes with full string tension on, it can be hard to grip these with your fingers, and you may not be able to even turn them by hand with full string tension. So you'd either need to loosen your strings to relieve some of the tension on the bridge so that you can turn them by hand, or you can use the spanner wrench from the screwdriver set to grip the thumb wheel, and you can turn it counterclockwise with one end of the wrench, or you can turn it clockwise with the other end of the wrench. So that's another easy way to raise or lower it with string tension on. Some Tunamatic bridges have a screwdriver recess in the top of the post, most Epiphones or import models. And for that, you can use a flat-bladed screwdriver bit, and you can turn the post up or down that way, and you don't have to use the thumb wheels. Basically, you will just turn your adjuster wheels up or down until your bridge is in the location that achieves the proper action at the 12th fret. On a guitar with individually adjustable saddles, you will use a screwdriver or Allen wrench to raise or lower the saddles with the small saddle screws that go through the saddles themselves. So this Telecaster has a flathead screw, so I'll get my flathead screwdriver. So using a flat-bladed screwdriver, I will turn the screw to the right to raise the saddle, or I will turn it to the left to lower the saddle. If you have a guitar that has six individually adjustable saddles, when you're done with your action adjustments, you'll want to make sure that the saddle bottoms are parallel to the bridge plate.
To perform your own setup, make sure you check out all Music Nomad's Keep It Simple setup gauges and tools. Not only is the Keep It Simple setup fun, but a properly set up guitar takes your playing and sound to a whole new level. That's Music Nomad quality, raising the bar in equipment care.